I'm Alyssa from Greenheck Dampers. Today, we're going to show you how to change an actuator mounting from external to internal. We'll start by taking the two screws on each side of the standoff bracket out, as well as the extension pin and clip. Here's a list of tools you will need to complete this conversion. You will need to determine which damper blade is the drive blade. If you have one or two blades, the bottom blade is the drive blade. If your damper has three or more blades, the drive blade is the third from the bottom. Start with the damper in the closed position. Measure 1.563 inches from the end of the blade and 0.875 inches above and below the center line of the blade and mark the holes. Drill two 13/64 inch holes in the damper blades. In your kit, you will find three blade brackets for the different blade types. In this case, you will use the blade drive lever part number 714549 because the damper I am mounting the bracket to is a 3V blade model. Refer to the installation instructions if you have a different blade type. Attach the blade drive lever by using the two fasteners provided. Start to install the actuator bracket by snapping the thicker bearing into the center hole. Line up the holes in the actuator bracket with the left jamb and mark the spot where the top hole will go. Drill a 13/64 inch hole in the frame. Fasten the actuator bracket to the holes in the left jamb of the damper frame using two 1/4 by 20 half inch studs and nuts through the holes in the damper frame. Use a thread cutting screw for the final hole. The bottom tab is not going to get a fastener. Secure the drive link onto the blade drive lever using the E-clip to lock it in place. Slide the half inch diameter shaft through the crank arm with the bolt facing outward from the damper and the round edge towards the bottom of the damper. Slide the shaft through the bearing onto the actuator bracket. Take the drive link and place it in the middle column and bottom row of the crank arm when hanging down and use the E-clip to lock it in place. Placement of the drive link may be adjusted as required for proper damper operation. Make sure that the drive link is straight up and down and fasten the crank arm bolt to the shaft. Snap the thin bearing into the anti-rotation bracket and slide it onto the half-inch shaft. Attach the anti-rotation bracket to the actuator bracket using thread cutting screws. You are now ready to install the actuator. Please reference the actuator installation manual for specific details.
I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please call us at 1-800-717-6540 or email us at dampers@greenheck.com. Greenheck will continue to lead the industry in new and innovative damper products and solutions.